First party data will absolutely, without question, be a key to marketer success in 2022 and beyond. If you have the type of business that you rely on consumer data, you're probably getting it direct from the data company itself or from a data list broker. If that's the case, I'd consider asking questions like, how often do you update the list? Where exactly do you get the list from? Are you sharing the same list with 10 of my competitors? That would concern me. The other thing that you should consider is that, as we all know, privacy rules laws have really ratcheted up. So the information that they're capable of getting isn't exactly the same as it was before, at least for these lists. We're in the first-party data business, and we're big believers in first-party data. The way we capture first-party data is we create private-labeled content, whether it be books or white papers or videos, and in exchange for consumers getting that information, they give us their contact information and agree to opt in. Think about the value of somebody beginning the process by knowing your brand already, by having you giving them something that's valuable to them, and you're already at a level that you're of engagement that's better than if you're renting a list and their first exposure to you is just asking them for an appointment or just out of the blue. They don't know who your brand is. When we first started doing this, we really weren't sure about what the success rate should be. And we were getting sales qualified leads in the beginning at about a 9% rate. And our clients, understandably, were like, hey, gee, why are like 90% of these leads aren't sales qualified leads? And we would allow ourselves to get beaten up until we realized that mailer lists and many of the lists were converting to sales qualified leads at about a 1% rate. So until that we really understood those metrics, we realized that, hey, we're kind of 1,000% ahead of the game here, and we are. Today, we convert to sales qualified leads at around a 12 to 15% rate. Still, the overwhelming majority of the first party data that we get are not sales qualified leads, but that's okay. It's still quantum leaps ahead of a lot of the other data that you might purchase. So first party data is a wonderful way to start. It's data that you own, it's data that you can communicate with on your own terms, and it's people who understand and already know your brand. So if you haven't considered the value of first party data, you should learn it and consider who you might want to talk to help you take advantage of your own first party data.